idea. You can put your hands together. Nitya Nandam Param Sukadam Kevalam Yanamurtim Ganga Titam Gagana Sadrisham Tattvamasya Dilaksham Ekam Nityam Vimalam Achalam Sarvadi Sakshi Bhutam Bhava Titam Trikuna Rajitam Satpurum Tam Namami. Okay, so we are going to learn about a truth today, which when you follow it in your life, you will have tremendous power, you will be all powerful. Okay, what do you mean by being all powerful? Supposing you declare that, okay, in this exam, I'm going to get the first rank. Do you have ranking system in your school? Yeah, so you declare and you say, I'm going to get the first rank. Just by uttering those words and taking the responsibility for it, you manage to get first mark. Then in your sports day, you declare by following this truth that I'm going to speak about. If you follow it, you will be all powerful. So if you declare that you're going to be the first in 100 meter dash, you will be the first. Okay? So whatever reality you want, you will be able to create by following this truth. You can even stop the sun, stop the sunshine, stop the rain. If you want, you can have the rain. So the power of this truth is phenomenal. You understand what I'm saying? Okay? So today, supposing you want to really play and it starts raining. So you can stop the rain with your words. You say, hey, I want to play for 20 minutes. Can you just stop for me? The rain will stop for you. But you should follow this truth that we are going to speak about today. Okay? So what do you think? What truth do you think it will be? Any guesses? Which is so powerful that you have so much Vak Siddhi. Vak Siddhi means what? Vak means word. Siddhi means power of word. Okay? So anybody wants to take any guess what this can be all about? This truth? Any other answers? Just take a guess. See, you should not be afraid and to just take a guess. Feel free, feel comfortable. If you have any doubts, you can always ask. Okay? Anybody else?
Magic words, okay.
What is the truth? When followed, will give you Vak Siddhi, will make you all powerful. Okay, so anybody, any other guess here? See, in those days, no, rishis used to be there, right? Because rishis, when they give a curse, you know, it becomes true. How many of you know the story of Mahabharata? Dronacharya, very good. So Dronacharya, he curses Karna, right? Whenever your knowledge, you need it most, you will forget it, and it becomes true. So how did he have that power? How did he have that power? Any guesses now? What is the truth?
Meditation.
Okay. Any other answers? Okay. Praying to God. Okay. So now you are going to hear the truth. The truth is the power of integrity. Okay. You know the meaning of integrity? Okay, integrity means whatever words you give yourself, you honor it. Whatever words you give others, you honor it. Okay, that is the meaning of integrity. Now, like, what do you mean by giving a word to others? Okay, so supposing you say, you tell your friend, hey, today we play, I'll be down at 4 o'clock to play with you. Okay? And she is waiting, waiting, waiting at 4 o'clock, 4:30, and you don't turn up. Is that being in integrity? You gave a word to her to be there at 4 o'clock, but you were not there. So are you in integrity or not? How many of you say no? Yeah. So you are not in integrity. Good. So you understood now what is the meaning of integrity. The words you give others, you keep. Okay? Now what about the words you give yourself? The words you give us yourself are thoughts. Basically, thoughts. Supposing you say, no, today I have to wake up early and go to school. Okay? So, but when your mother comes and wakes you up, you are like, oh, another 10 minutes, another 20 minutes, please, I'm sleepy. And then you miss the bus. Are you in intercity? No. You didn't give the word to your mother that you wanted to be in time for school, but you gave a word to yourself. You thought, right? The thought that you thought inside your mind to yourself is the word you gave yourself. Okay? Now you understood how you must honor every word you give yourself and every word you give others. Because every time, what will happen? Okay? Take that example. When you told your friend you'd come and play with her at 4 o'clock and you didn't turn up, what will that friend think of you? What will go on her mind? What will she think of you? See, you must be interactive. We want answers from you. Raise your hand, I'll bring the mic to you. Whoever wants to answer. What will that friend think of you? Next time you tell her you'll come at 4 o'clock, will she believe you? No. Okay, so what will she think of you?
She'll feel bad.
Okay, she'll feel bad, but what will she think of you? What will she think of you? You put yourself in that situation. You're waiting for your friend, she didn't come. What will you think of her? It's okay, who else wants? Okay, yeah.
Laziness.
She'll think that you're lazy. Okay, what else will she think of you?
She will not believe me.
Right, very good. She won't believe you. She won't have any confidence on your words. You have heard of the word confidence? Okay, so she won't have any confidence on your words. Very good. So, just like that, see, others won't believe you. You won't believe yourself. Next time you think and sleep, tomorrow morning I must get up early and be in time to school. One part of your mind will be laughing at you. Hey, you, getting up early. Come on, forget it. So what happens? You yourself don't believe you. You see? So you don't have confidence on yourself also. You understand? So what happens? Others don't have confidence on you. You don't have confidence on yourself. How many of you think it's okay if others don't have confidence? I also don't have confidence. Can you do anything in your life? Can you achieve anything in your life? So, what is the definition of success? What is the definition of success? Come, somebody answer. What do you think success means?
Doing achievement in the life. Great achievement.
Very good. So, creating achievement in the life. Success. Any other answers we have for success? We have any other answers for success? Yeah, come. Come forward. Come.
Achieving your aim.
Achieving your aim. Okay. So, how can you achieve your aim? You have to believe in yourself. Right. You have to have self-confidence. Very good. You have to have, others must have confidence on you. Right? Supposing you go to a big company and you're a big IT professional, you become a big IT professional, you know, you're doing your computer job, then your boss calls you and he gives you, hey, I'm handing this project to you. Then you should have confidence, self-confidence that you can finish it, and your boss should have confidence in you to give the project to you. Right? But if you're a person who doesn't have integrity, he won't have confidence on you, you won't have confidence on yourself. You understand? So, you understand how important it is to be in integrity. Okay? You understood? So, every time you are not integrated, every time you don't follow the word you give others, every time you don't follow the word you give yourself, you become weak. You become powerless. Okay? Every time you follow the word you give yourself and you follow the word you give others, you become all powerful and you become integrated and you become strong. Okay? And you become successful. So, you got the idea about integrity? Okay. So, anybody would like to summarize what is integrity now? Anybody would like to summarize what is integrity? Till what we have done, just gather the main points. What is integrity? Okay, what will happen if you don't follow integrity? What is integrity from what you have learned now? Come, come, one of you come and tell. There are two parts to integrity, right? One is with yourself and one is with others. Yeah, you tell. You're answering nicely. You should have confidence in yourself, right? We're talking about integrity here. Come on. What is integrity?
Others should believe us. If we give them work, we should take work.
You should keep the word you give others. You should keep the word you give yourself. Correct. Okay, so that is integrity. So what happens if you don't follow integrity? Do you get stronger or do you get weaker? Weaker. So, do you have confidence on yourself if you are not in integrity? No. So, you have to be in integrity. Only then you will have confidence on yourself and others will have confidence in you. Okay, so we just do a small exercise. Okay? So, supposing you are a king. Okay? Imagine you are all the kings of a country. Okay? You are a king of a country. What will your responsibilities be? Okay? I want volunteers to answer. I want different volunteers to answer each time. Okay? So anybody please, which king is going to come forward and put forth his responsibilities? Come on, you are all the kings now. Come. Kings don't sit there and say, oh, it's okay. They are leaders. Right? Come on. Come on, all of you are leaders now. Come. Who, which king wants to come and tell his responsibilities? Come on. Who? See, he's already ready. What is your name? He's already ready. He's wanting to come and tell. But I want to keep other questions. What is your name? Come here. What is your name? Very nice, Mantesh. That is good. So, you tell. And then the next three will jump to the other. You are the king. What would your responsibility be here?
Respect for people. Respect for people.
Whenever there is something to settle between two people, if there is a fight, he will give justice, right? Then he takes care of the people, he takes care of their needs, right? If they want something, they go and tell the king, see, we need a temple tank here, there is no water. You know, all those problems, they go and tell the people. So he takes care to see that they have all their basic needs, right? Their basic needs are taken care of, the children are educated, nobody lies or steals. What else? You can think of anything else? So he respects his people, he helps his people. Very good. What else? Very good, very good. So, very nice. So, if you, the king gives the word, he should follow it. Very good. Very good. Main quality of the king. Because then only the subjects will know. Okay, we've taken a problem to the king, he'll definitely solve it. That confidence they have on the king.
You should solve the people's problems.
You should solve the people's problems. Now you are told all the should give them what they wish. What happens when you wish for something that's not good for you? Very good. God won't give it to you because His love and compassion is such that sometimes He knows what is best for you. Even if you ask Him something that's not good for you, He won't. Very good understanding. Okay, move on. So He takes care that people who don't are bad, He says, are taking care of. It's not punishing, basically. They should act fairly. If they don't act fairly, then they are not an integrity. So obviously, whatever they ask for doesn't matter. should be the best student.
School discipline.
You should follow school discipline. Very.
You should always help the teachers.
You should always help the teachers. Very good. That is a helping mentality. Wherever you are, now you are helping your teachers. When you go out, you will be helping your society. When you go home, you will help your parents. See, cleanliness is also your responsibility. You know, your hair sticking out like that, and your shoes not polished, and dirty uniform. You come like that, is nice. No, right? So it's responsibility. It's your responsibility. You come clean, be dressed. Very good. That is being in integrity with time. That's very nice. So she says you should follow the time and be on time for all the classes and teachers. You have to help them and be happy with them. That's very nice. If other, when others are doing a mistake, we should tell them. That's very nice point. That speaks about your authenticity. Many people, when you see somebody else, you know, cheating in an exam, they say, oh, you know, what for me, let her cheat. That's not being authentic. You have to point out to the teacher, hey, he's cheating, he's copying, right? So it is your duty, it is your responsibility. Be very manner, very good. Very nice. See, he thought about the school surroundings. You must keep it cleanly. That's very, very good. Very good. We should be good to teachers and we should respect teachers. Because they are coming all the way to teach you. They have a home, right? They're getting ready in time. So this program is called Nitya Nanda. Israel.